So this is one of those videos that people have been asking me to kind of some questions about it. And training the horses, you know, it kind of brought me to where I am, but it was a sort of weird accident. I got bucked off a horse and I was trying to get it going before the clinic and it bucked me off. And it hurt a little, but the clinic goes on and I needed the money and everybody showed up and kept going and they're like, man, are you okay? And I was like, yeah, I'm fine. And I see a little bit of blood in my spit there. And they're like, well, no, we can really do the clinic another day. And I'm like, no, we'll do the clinic now. I'm fine, you know, kind of cowboy way. And I kept coughing up a little more blood here and there. And pretty soon they're like, no, you should go to the hospital. You know, you could have internal bleeding or something else going on there. And I'm like, I'm like, yeah, maybe I should go. So I started to walk and it was like the Looney Tunes commercial. And it went from color to black and white to nothing. And I couldn't see. I was walking, I could talk, I was coherent, but I couldn't see. And I was trying to get to my truck. I can't remember whether I was going to drive or somebody was going to drive me. But when I couldn't see, I kind of panicked and laid down. And I said, call the ambulance. Or no, somebody else was already called the ambulance at that point. And I didn't have any money, so I was like, don't call the ambulance. Let's just throw me in the truck. I remember telling them, throw me in the truck. I'll get there. Just throw me in the truck. I can get to the hospital faster than the ambulance can get here. And they wouldn't listen. So the ambulance came, took him about 45 minutes. But as soon as I laid down, I could see again. I could walk. I could talk. The ambulance got there. You know, I remember things in the ambulance ride. And they're like, he's coherent times 10. And they call it a gray out. Basically, it's kind of like a panic attack. But I know riding horses and all the concussions and broken bones and everything starting colts, I always wondered what I would do if something happened. And so for me, I didn't have the money to invest in things. So I looked at real estate and I would find deals in real estate. And I figured those renters could actually at least pay down the mortgage, which would allow some money to be invested for me towards my retirement. And yeah, it's another job, but through the years, we've gotten some great renters and I'm just amazed. I got more stories to tell you. There's a really cool one about water lines breaking and everything here recently. But anyways, that allowed us to have multiple rentals, and some of them are paid off and some of them are not paid off, but that now is pretty much our income. And the training and the clinics and all that, that's just bonus. And that was kind of the idea of this YouTube channel, is to try to get back to some folks some things for us, because I see a lot of people and they're doing videos and they've got this and buy that, and I don't know. I hate to say it, because maybe there'll be something that for sale or to go deeper. You guys know, you've seen it. There's not a lot of editing involved, so I don't know much about that. Again, I'm just a cowboy, but that's kind of how this came about, and I cannot stress enough how much that society plays down, and I was so afraid to invest in the stock market. And the stock market, it seems like every time you listen, it's going down, it seemed to me. But what you don't realize is the last few years, if you missed the best day in the stock market, you missed, I think it was 17% of your gains just in one day. And if you missed the two best, it was like 23%. And if you miss like the six best, you miss like 40% of your gains in the last couple of years. And the point is it might go down, but when it goes down, usually it might spike up. And I always talk about the economy being like a rubber band effect, you know. Slowly over time, like for our rental properties, that's how we expanded. Well, a lot of times you get rich, people, and if you let go, it just snaps back. So we can kind of let go now with the rental properties and it doesn't just snap back. And yeah, there's some hard times in my wife's medical bills. I mean, the first week was $333,000 just for 1 week of medical bills. Thank God insurance covered part of that. And, you know, we still got a large copay and a large deductible, but we're so blessed to have what we are because I couldn't work. For months, I couldn't work. And I'm back to work now. Some of it to pay for a bunch of medical bills too. But I say blessed, but it's also that financial IQ to take the strive to invest a little bit. You know, find something. Find a dividend stock or something that pays you over time and just set that money away. Anyways, you know, find your passion. You know, for me, it's riding horses and now the Tesla. I know some of you. I know, but I do love my Tesla. And I love going to the lake, you know, and that's, look forward to going to Europe and Switzerland. And I'm no longer boat people. I sold my boat last year, but I'll get to go to a boat there. I got a good friend here. We're going to go out this week. But, you know, it allows some time to go do some things. But over time, that little 5%, 10%, whatever investment over 10 years, that replaces it. You know, so just take a little time and invest something. But also invest in yourself. All right. I hope you guys enjoy this. Happy trails. Adios.